Peter Sharples arrived in New York, few people knew about it. The Minister of Māori Development was a key speaker at the opening ceremony of the UN's Forum on Indigenous Issues.
We need development that allows Indigenous peoples to exercise their right to self-determination through participation in decision-making on an equal basis.
Peter Sharples' turn at the podium began Māori style. Members of Kahurangi, a group of New York-based Māori, had been asked to support the minister, but weren't briefed about his speech. In fact, some members of his own party, other government ministers, and the media weren't told a thing about the visit. The minister began his speech with a formal chant, not an easy thing to interpret, even with a team of UN translators. But the focus of 2,000 delegates was on him.
Were you nervous about this?
No, I wasn't nervous at all. I was totally excited, though.
Having a speech on international record checked the minister's excitement and his tendency to improvise. But even with a translation in English, the punchline of his speech sailed over the heads of most delegates. It took another minute and a half before the news in English sank in.
I come with humble heart to celebrate the Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous People. The New Zealand government has long discussed this matter and has recently decided to support it.
Our Hawaiian cousins were vocal in their praise, as were delegates on the floor.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. About time, isn't it?
Yeah. But when the news broke back home, the proverbial hit the political fan.
The declaration is divisive, and it is a further step for New Zealand down a path of a divided nation.
Why would you sign up to something that you never intended to act on and you don't actually believe in?
Supporting the declaration is a gesture they can make without giving over anything.
Others, though, were all smiles.
Declaration's been signed, all done and dusted, we're really happy.
The media was critical of the secrecy surrounding the signing. The Māori Party received requests under the Official Information Act for all correspondence leading up to the announcement. It was UN red tape and protocol that dictated the manner and nature of how the announcement was made, as well as the need to stay on side with our diplomatic buddies, Australia, Canada and the US. Bilateral talks like these helped nail our position and followed Australia's endorsement of the declaration last year and Canada's agreement to take steps to sanction it this year. And our decision helped Native Americans compel the US to change its tune.
Thus, today I'm pleased to announce that the United States has decided to review our position regarding the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples.
The pressure is on, and it's not easy for those two countries to consider all the things they've got to do, but Susan Rice for United States said they're going to review their situation and be judged by how they react to that, which is quite a powerful thing to say. And as for the Canadians, they said they've got still work to do, but they're hoping to clinch something within a year.
Peter Sharples says by signing up to the declaration, we now have a tool of international law that protects Māori as an Indigenous people.
We have to do something, measures to ensure equality, and that's got to be good for all New Zealand. And it allows us to participate with strength and clarity in issues of global importance. And it's a reminder back to us in New Zealand that we have obligations as well.
such as defending the rights of other Indigenous peoples, 5,000 distinct groups in 70 countries around the world. And their protection is a big job. For instance, it's predicted that 90% of all Indigenous languages, including Māori, could disappear within 20 years. Although the declaration is non-binding, it strengthens debate about the treaty and what meaning can be given to both documents.
The big task for us is to have this review of New Zealand's constitution, and in particular the treaty, and where does it fit in our lives, because the whole rata in the church, for example, is dedicated to, one whole side of them is dedicated to giving the treaty its true status in New Zealand. And then you've got the other churches, and you've got iwi, and you've got the northern people where it started to be signed, and everybody, we're passionate about having the treaty take its place in our constitution and in our way of life. It is a binding document.
One last note to the story. At the end of Peter Sharple's speech, Pinepine Te Kura, a Ngāti Kahununu chant, was sung in honour of the minister's tribal affiliations. One of those who learnt it was this former National MP, now ambassador.
We learned it. We had someone from Kahurangi come in and teach it to us. We all had it on our MP3s. We listened to it and we sang it every lunch hour. And when I was going up and down the elevator, I was going to get the rhythm right.
So understanding takes time and brings a new way of looking at things.